All right, welcome back to OD5. This is Chris coming at you in the kitchen again today. I'm actually bringing to you, believe it or not, another method of cleaning pufferfish. I did find another pufferfish cleaning method, and I want to show it to you because, you know, here at OD5, it's not about my way. It's about working smarter and not harder. The video is actually called How to Clean Pufferfish the Easy Way, and this is actually another guy named Chris. So shout out to you. This video has been up for about a year, so I'm about to show you the method that he uses on this one, and you be the judge. You know, you might like the method that I've already shown you, or you might like the method that Chris uses on his. So here we go. All right, so here's our pufferfish. If you remember from the method that I showed you, you know, basically I was cutting around the crown of the head here, and then of course pulling, you know, putting my fingers inside the skin here, and then pulling the fish inside out. All right, so this method is a little bit different. So as you can see here, I have the fish upside down, and you can see that it actually has a little fin underneath here, which I don't really even know if I noticed before, but basically you're gonna grab it by this little fin down here, and you need a sharp knife to do this. So hopefully my knife is up to the task. And basically you're just cutting through. So basically you're just cutting through. Now hold on to that little fin tight. Then once you get to the top of the fish, you're just cutting down like that, and then you're lifting your meat right up out of there like that. All right, so that's what we just did. I'm gonna do another one of those. All right, so we're just holding on to our little fin here, and we're letting our knife just run right through the fish here. We're just gonna hold on. Once we get our initial cut started there. All right, then we're turning our knife down into the fish, cutting through the backbone, and then we're just lifting up on that fish. Just like that. All right, so that's another method for cleaning them here. So. Pretty fast. Now before you, I have my ingredients. I'm going to show you how I do my beer batter. Actually, I'm going to do the pufferfish since I just cleaned those up, showing you the method that Chris used over on how to clean pufferfish the easy way. So I have some of my little extra spicy powders here, a little Sri Lankan spicy mix here. One of my buddies brought back. Shout out to Rajiv. Thank you. And Elvin. I have my dry fish powder, my dry fish batter here, so in a bowl. We have one egg that we're gonna use in a part of our mixing here, and then we have a little bowl of beer. So I just have some beer here. We're not advertising, so we just put it in a bowl for you. All right, so this is how this is gonna come together. All right, so I have my little bowl here. I'm just gonna hold this up top. So in my little bowl, I'm actually going to put my egg. So egg into bowl. All right, and then I'm just gonna put a little bit of my fish batter here into here with this egg, just a little bit. I'm gonna use the majority of this for coating. So we're just getting a little wet batter going. And then we have our beer here. All right, so in with the beer. All right, and I'm not gonna use it all just yet. All right, so we got that. We're gonna get that nice and mixed up. All right, so we're doing that. And you can see it's pretty runny here, but this is really just a wash, more of a wash than anything. All right, I'm gonna put a little bit more batter in here for that. Just I wanted a little more texture there. All right, so we're gonna get that mixed up. All right, so that's a done deal. And now we're just gonna bring our fish into the mix here. All right, so our fish are actually gonna go directly into our little batter mix, which is really essentially just a little wash. So we're just gonna get those in there, let them get happy. All right, so we have about 10 of these puffers here. We're just getting them all in there. work them in there like that. Get them nice and mixed up. All right, let that sit for a minute. All right, so we have another bowl here now. So with our next bowl, our dry batter's going in. And because I want my fish a little extra spicy today, that's where my Sri Lankan spice is gonna come in. They're gonna go in there. So they're gonna go in there and get mixed up, and then we're coming back with our whisk. Make sure that that spice is mixed up nicely. All right, so with that, we have everything else cleaned up here and out of the way. So now we just have our fish that's in the beer batter here, and we have our dry fish batter here. So we're coming out of the wet, and we're going into the dry, and we're shaking. All right, so again, out of the wet, into the dry, and we're shaking. Just like that. All right, so we have another little plate in the equation here now, so we're just taking these out, and we're gonna put them right on our plate here until we're ready to go into the fryer. All right, so again, out of the wet, into the dry, we're shaking. Out of the wet, into the dry, we're shaking. You see the size of the bowl I have, I can get away with putting three puffers in here before I have to make room. All right, so now we're going again onto our little dry plate here that's holding our fish. Just like that. All right, and that's gonna be our method to the madness until we're done. Out of the wet, into the dry, onto the plate. All right, so there's our plate ready to go. So the next thing we'll do, put them in the fryer and fry them up. All right, just popping in, giving you a quick shout of the action there. They'll be up in a minute. All right, stay tuned. I did want to pop back in, let you see my plate. You can see I have my puffers over here looking as good as they want to look. And my little green beans and sincerely Thrifty Kimmy's mashed potatoes. That's the bomb right there. So I'm sorry you can't share this plate with me. This is Chris, signing out.